Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm your trainer Arun Chauhan and I'm back again with another video. As I promised in my last video of the 100 questions for IELTS writing task 2 that I'll be uploading questions for the academic people of task 1. So in this video, we're going to talk about some questions that are, you know, you can get an idea sample questions for the IELTS examination that are going to come from September till December 2021. So watch this till last, watch this video, and if you like the video, click like, share with your friends. Apart from this, please make sure you are staying safe in this corona times, and for your IELTS preparation, please read the newspaper daily. Apart from this, if any of you is facing any kind of problem in the four module of IELTS, that is writing, speaking, listening, reading, please feel free to write me down at my email, that is IELTSwitharun@gmail.com. You can see at the bottom of your screen. Apart from this, if anyone requires any kind of IELTS material for any of the four modules, please feel free to write me down. I'll be more than happy to send you those kind of material. Apart from this, I have uploaded already, you know, the essay question video. You can check that video. Apart from this, there are so many videos on my channel and there's separate playlist. You can go, you can check them out. They will be highly helpful for you. I'm sure about that. So apart from this, if anyone is looking for online IELTS classes, you can get in touch with me. I'm also doing IELTS essay evaluation. So let's not waste time and go to my computer screen to check the task 1 questions. IELTS writing task 1. IELTS graph. The very first question is a kind of process chart that shows a gas-cooled nuclear reactor in which there are some charge tubes for loading fuel elements, and there's a hot gas conduct, and there's a steam to turbo alternator. So it's basically a process that's showing a nuclear reactor. What all is going in a nuclear reactor? What are the inlets and what are the outlets? Like there's a gas blower. What all process is happening in the nuclear reactor? So like it's basically a process chart. In process chart, you don't have to do anything. You just need to follow the flow and need to explain it. The next kind of question is again a process chart. Is basically showing the use of trash. You know, people put their trash in the used cans that is basically collected by the garbage trucks. Then it basically goes in the area where it is sorted, cleaned and shredded. And then from that, basically the metals are heated and it's melted. Then it is turned into a rolling sheet and then the recycling happens. And like 74% of stuff, you know, Coca are used for recycling the Coca-Cola cans. And the cold drink cans basically into this. So this is a aluminium cycle totally. You don't have much to do into this. You just can, you know, directly explain. The next is again a process chart. You know, first I put some process chart, then you'll be seeing one or two maps. Then same, there will be more bar graphs, table charts that you will find in this. So it's basically a fish pie that is the complete product. And fish pie, you basically see like there is no fish, sauce, peas, potato in it. But how the process is happening, it's shown in the second picture. So you basically see that the truck come, it brings potatoes that is basically then cleaned, and then it's peeled in a machine, then they're sliced, and then they're boiled, and then they're again chilled, and then, you know, then they put on some like in different thing, they're basically stored, all right, and then they are sent into a bowl, then sauce is added, then prepared peas are added, then there is a person over there who's inspecting it on the conveyor belt, then others are there who remove the skins and bones, then it's basically, you know, steamed in the oven, then they sprinkle some salt in it, then some lemon juice, you know, fresh salmon, this is basically a fish, you know, I basically told like, you know, a separate one. It's basically, it will start from here. Fresh salmon, the lemon juice is sprinkled, then some salt, then go in the steam oven, and then there are people to inspect it, and then the final wrapping happens, and after the wrap, it is gone in the freezing process, and in the frozen process, then it's basically stored and dispatched. Next is a map. Now, it's basically showing the university campus. It used to be in 2010, and then how the university campus basically looks now. So it's, you know, you need to draw the references between a past and present. So be very careful while describing the maps, because a lot of people forget to use the word had when they're talking about past. So be very careful about it. You just see like, you know, the buildings have been changed. Now we are having modern buildings. Student accommodation is increased. Then the lake was there. The size has been decreased. So there's more student accommodation or near the restaurant. Now the restaurant is not there. So they've changed it. You need to just explain. So these are basically questions. You know, you can just go through these questions. You can try to solve them. There isn't much for me to explain in this. You know, this is because this is a pictorial representation. You would have seen, you would have solved already. So these are basically practice. For this practice, I made this 50 questions. You can just go through this 50 questions. And you know, you really gonna enjoy it. You are practicing this thing. Then again, this is a campus, Langley. How used to Langley look like in 1910? And how Langley looks in 1950? There was a wasteland. Now they have completely converted the wasteland. There's Sherman mansions have come up. Initially, it was used to Sherman Street, and there was more houses. Now there are more mansions, right? Now there are bigger houses. The laundry is present, the cafe is there, but the store has changed its places. So the Sherman Park has gone. The children's play area has come in. So there's so many changes that has happened, right? Then you'll see a bar graph over here. The bar graph is basically saying the chart below shows the main reasons for study among students of different age groups and the amount of support they received from employers. So it's basically a chart. It shows, you know, the main reason why people went to study again as a student. And then there's a separate chart. It is showing the kind of support they received from their employers. So the first chart is like what age group people went for studying, right? Like for interest in career, for the interest of a career. And the next chart shows what age group people received, how much kind of support from their employers. Then the next is basically a line chart. This is the first line chart in this one, right? That's agriculture, industrial use, and domestic use. So it's basically showing the global water use by sectors. Next is again, it's like, you know, it's a process chart of generating electricity. There isn't much. They're drawing the water from the cliff, then the water is going on the turbine and it's coming out of chamber, waves are generated. Same in process, you don't have much to write. What basically is, okay, in bar charts. You know, in bar charts, what you have to do is you have to be very careful, right? You know, these are the exact places where you draw the references. Like, you know, it shows 25%, like, for example, it's always showing skateboarding, bike riding, watching, and then arts and craft. So at places you can see this equal number of people were watching TV and videos. So it's basically showing the yellow one stands for girls at the age of 5 to 14, and for the pink is age 5 to 14. So watching television was common in both, the equal number of people, 100% in their age were watching television. But when it came to skateboarding, the boys were on the higher side, the girls were on the lower side. And similarly, when it came to art and craft, more girls were involved in art and craft compared to the boys. So this is how you need to find things which are in common. First, you'll note the highest point and you'll talk about the lowest. Then you'll find the points which are common. Same again, table chart. This is again process. This is kind of bar, inverted bar. Okay, this is again a line graph. It's basically showing two new music websites on the web and how they, you know, the number of visits they had in the following days. So there was, like, you know, on some point on the day 9th, you can see there was a sharp rise in one website. And same for the blue one, it was sharp rise on the 11th. Then they saw a fall. Initially, the growth was less for the blue one, okay, for the music choice, and then it rose slightly. So this is how you need to draw the references. So like, these are so many questions, it's really not possible for me to discuss all these questions out here. So like, what are the best thing is, you know, this is again a chart. The best thing is that if you want this email, you can write me down at my email address, that is ielswitherun@gmail.com, and in the subject you mention that you need this file, and I'll be more than happy to send you this file, right? And I'll send you this 50 question file. Then you can check this file and you can solve all the questions. And still you face a problem, you can ask me, right? You can write me down. And apart from this, I also made a 100 question task 2 video also. Please go and check that out. So like, there were so many pie charts, line chart again, bar, then again a bar. Then there's again a process of shading from sheep to the final jackets. It's basically yarn thing. Then again a line chart, line, bar, bar chart, bar charts line, and bar chart common mix charts basically. Bar charts, line charts. So people like, these are the maximum charts. So, you know, those who have not following me on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. I daily upload a new reel, which is, you know, highly effective and useful. And if for the writing corrections officers, you have my email address over here that you can read. That is IELTSwitharun@gmail.com. Hey people, as you saw the questions of task one, there are so many questions and it's really not possible to read out all those questions. So what I'm offering is, if anyone is looking forward to get a hold of this soft copy about the task and questions, please feel free to write me down in the comment section. Or the best thing is, you can email me at IELTSwitharun@gmail.com. Please, in the subject, do mention what you're looking forward for. Is it the task and questions you're looking forward for, or it is the 100 IELTS essay question that you're looking forward for? Please be specific, so it will be easier for me, easier for you. When I send you the material, you can use it. So if you like the video, click like, share it with your friends. Those who have not subscribed my channel, please make sure you subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can receive all the notifications, as I'll be uploading more interesting content in the coming weeks. Apart from this, make sure you go and check my other videos as well. Till then, I'm your trainer Arun Chauhan. All the best for your examination and stay safe.